proposal is to hopefully upgrade Missouri roads into the 21st century, and it's a 1 cent sales tax that'll go on the state base tax rate, and it's got a 10-year sunset. So if MoDOT's doing their due diligence in 10 years, the voters can vote in another 10-year extension. If not, then they can end it at that time. But it's got some protections in there that protects the average taxpayer. You know, MoDOT will be reviewed by a joint committee in the legislature after 5 years, and we'll see where they're at that point. So there's a little bit of protection for the consumer at that point. It also does not allow the fuel tax to be raised during the 10 years, and it does not allow for any toll roads to go in the state. So, you know, it's a common sense approach to our funding issue. The federal government, we can't rely on them with the budget deficit that's taken place in Washington, D.C., so we have to go about it our own way, and several states across the nation are starting to do that, try to do something with their transportation needs. The closest state to us that did something recently was Arkansas, and they have started their projects now, and their economy down there is booming just off of the road construction that's taken place. So hopefully we can get folks back to work with this proposal and you know, get some good safe roads. Being from a rural community, we have several deaths that take place every year, and most of it's due to people dropping a tire off the road because there's no shoulders, and usually it's a 2 or 3 foot drop off, and they overcorrect and they either roll the vehicle or hit someone else head on. So, you know, MoDOT has a plan in place where they want to widen the shoulders, add 2 foot to those minor roads, as they call them, and put rumble strips in. Those have been great safety additions that MoDOT's done. And so they want to widen, you know, I-70 to make better traffic flow across the state from east to west. And I think the time's perfect because MoDOT's funding has drastically been reduced. It's been cut in half from 5 years ago, and it's projected to be cut in half again by 2017. So if we don't do anything now, we're going to be at a critical situation here in about 3 years. And then the people definitely won't like the situation we're put in. I'm a business owner also, and you know, I have to get my deliveries, comes via transportation, and whenever I sell products to customers, it's via transportation. So all business owners are affected by transportation across the state, and most business owners want to be by an area that has good traffic flow. And that's the key to business, is location, location. And part of that is being on a good road that's safe, that your customers want to visit. The fuel tax would have to be raised between 25 and 28 cents to be able to accomplish what MoDOT needs to do. And I don't think the average voter is going to want to see their fuel tax go up that much. Where the base of the 1% is spread out across to everyone, because everyone uses transportation whether they own a vehicle or not. They're using it to get their medicine or their food brought in, or everyone leaves their home, so they're using some type of transportation to get out. And that's why we've opened up this issue to for the urban areas. If they want to expand their bus service or their light rail service, they can do that with this bill. Once this makes it through the legislative process, we need the chamber members out there promoting this, because a lot of these folks are their voice of their community with other things. Usually chamber members at the local level aren't just chamber members or Lions Club members, they're Rotary members. So they're the voice that can get out there and help spread the word.